True to their host's word, the driver did in fact arrive later that evening in another gilt speeder. Ka met the driver at the entry of the compound, graciously thanking him for his timeliness, and begging his patience as they waited for Kesarah. Ka had selected one of the many outfits that Kesarah had picked out for him, a set of formal pants and tunic in a charcoal hue with a dark shoulder cape and a calf boots. He felt a little ridiculous in all honesty, but seeing that Kesarah had gone to all the effort of choosing his wardrobe, it seemed only polite to oblige her in wearing it. "Sorry to make you wait," came Kesara's voice from behind them. Ka turned and froze for a moment as he spied his partner. The driver, too, seemed stunned as Kesarah walked towards them, a decidedly unashamed smile on her face. She'd chosen a full-length silver dress that shimmered in the light. It had a slit up to its left side to allow leg movement. It came up to her hip, where it hugged her stomach and chest before wrapping around her neck, leaving her shoulders bare. Her arms were clad in full-length fingerless gloves that started just below her shoulder and went down to the back of her hand, connecting to a small ring on her middle finger. The entire thing was sealed with a cape, with a black backing that hung around her shoulders and served call attention to the dress itself, but also Kesarah's light red skin as well. She beamed as she joined them, her face light with pleasure. "I hope I didn't keep you," she said. Ka shook his head, regaining his composure and voice. "Not at all. You look lovely." Her smile widened as she looped her arm through his and turned to look at the driver, who still seemed rather undone by her. "We're ready," she declared. Seeing not only that Ka had decided to wear one of the outfits she had picked for him, but also the expression on his face upon seeing what she was wearing had sent a rush of exhilaration through Kesara's body. She loved the reactions of others, especially when they were in relation to her. Now that he was dressed properly, she could actually agree with Fern's earlier assessment that he was in fact quite cute, handsome even. The long hair really did it for her, she had to admit. It was unusual enough to see any male, especially human males, with shoulder-length hair that Ka's hip-length hair really stood out. Of course, that didn't mean she planned on spending the entire evening on his arm, but making an entrance with someone with such a notable feature was nothing but good. It was just one more thing to draw the attention of others. The driver led the way to their speeder, which Kesarah was delighted to see was of a similar quality to their earlier ride, and she and Ka climbed into the back together. "So," Kesarah asked, as she leaned against Ka's arm, "you like the dress?" His nervous smile sent a shiver through her leku, causing her to lean against him as much as a tease as a reward for his participation. "It's enchanting," he replied earnestly. Kesarah giggled, enjoying his choice of words. "Are you saying that I cast a spell over you, Ka?" He swallowed, his smile remaining in place, though it was obviously strained. He was proving far more fun than she'd have expected him to be. "You are very beautiful," he said finally by way of an answer. Kesarah smiled at him endearingly. "You're sweet," she planted a kiss on his cheek. "Don't think I've forgotten about our dance." Ka's smile was flustered, and he shifted beside her nervously, which only served to further endear him to Kesarah. She was enjoying this, perhaps a little more than she should have been, but still this entire thing was about rubbing elbows with the planet's nobility. What good was it if she didn't have some fun while she was at it? Still holding on to Ka's arm, she looked up at him curiously. "What were your parents like?" she inquired. "Did they send you to train with the Jedi?" "My parents are Jedi," he replied. "They trained my brothers and I." "Those two boys who saw us off?" Kesarah asked. "They look a lot like you." Ka's smile was sheepish as he replied, "Triplets." "Really?" Kesarah asked in surprise. "That's actually pretty rare for Twi'leks. Sometimes we have twins, and they're considered precious and are highly prized, but never triplets." She hesitated a moment, frowning slightly. "What's that like, having other beings that are identical to you?" "We're not the same person," he answered quietly. "In fact, each of us is quite a bit different from one another." "So," Kesarah asked playfully, "what makes you different from your brothers?" "Well, Trey is the oldest of the three of us. He's also probably the strongest of us in terms of raw power." "Can you do what you did earlier, with your senses? Or the telepathy?" Kesarah inquired. "No, nothing like that. His powers are all kinetic and energy-based. He can rip a fighter out of its flight path and throw it around like a toy, or absorb a shot from a turbolaser and direct the energy back." Kesarah blinked in surprise. "That sounds impressive. What about the other brother?" She smiled at him teasingly. "Are you the baby?" "No," Ka answered with a smile. "Say's the youngest. He's the healer, and he has some seer capabilities, too." "Are they as quiet as you?" Kesarah teased, imagining having three shy, good-looking young men doting on her whims. "No. Say and I have a lot in common, but Trey is much more aggressive." Ka shifted for a moment, as if considering whether or not he should continue before he spoke. "Trey actually said he envied me for going on this mission with you." Kesara's rich brown eyes lit up, her leku twitching. "Oh?" she purred with pleasure. "Maybe I should have taken him as my partner." "Well, he and Say were sent to deal with pirates," Ka said with a sudden smirk. "So you're stuck with me." "Poor me," Kesarah pouted playfully. "So what kind of tricks do you have? You're a telepath, you have powerful force senses, anything else?" "A few," Ka replied. "We didn't elaborate," Kesarah prompted him. "Such as?" You're a shadow trained too, Kesarah, he said with a teasing smile of his own. You should know some of what we can do. Oh, so you know about that, Kesarah said, leaning back in the seat. So can you do this? As she spoke, she concentrated and bent the light around herself, and she vanished from view. She didn't move from her seat, but she was no longer visible. Ka nodded, smirking as he too faded from sight. Kesarah reappeared with a giggle, shaking her head as she imagined what sort of mischief two people who could turn invisible could get up to. Not that she expected Ka to be up for it. He'd probably object to anything she proposed. So, she began again, Ka, Trey, and Say. Parents weren't very creative, were they? It represents a word, Ka said as he reappeared. It's our mother's language, Trikase. What does that mean? Kesarah inquired. Love, Ka replied. That threw Kesarah off, and she stumbled for a response as the red-pink hue of her cheeks darkened and her lekku spasmed. She hadn't been expecting that, and had to admit for the first time in their interactions, Ka had managed to throw her off. She was saved from any more embarrassment as the speeder settled down on the landing pad and the driver hopped open to open the door. We have arrived, he said as he bowed his head. Kesarah quickly swung her legs out of the speeder, putting a smile on her face to hide the fluster that she'd just endured as Ka came up beside her. She looped her arm through his, smiling up at him as she regained her composure. Shall we? She inquired playfully, wiping away the momentary discomfort. He nodded. Let's go meet the locals. Ka hadn't meant to throw Kesarah off, but that he had was undeniable. She'd obviously been flirting with him, and to be honest, he'd been enjoying her banter and answering her questions. When he'd explained where his name originated from, though, she'd frozen. He hadn't needed to pry into her thoughts since what had set her off, either. The word love, that had been the trigger. He wondered what experiences in her life had made that word so anathema to her. It was something to keep in mind for later, he decided, as they walked down the path to the royal palace. There were guards with large pikes lining the path, wearing ceremonial armor. Ka didn't bother glancing at them, instead using his four senses to monitor their attentions, which invariably were centered on Kesarah as she walked beside him. She seemed all too aware of the attention that was being directed her way, and even though they had not yet entered the palace itself, she especially seemed to revel in emphasizing her connection to Ka, as if to say that she was already spoken for and thereby out of reach of the watchful guards. It was very strange behavior to Ka, used to more reserved Jedi than this. Kesarah seemed intent on flaunting her status and looks. Reaching the entryway to the palace itself, which was crafted out of white marble with gold spires and towers gracing it, the doors swung open on their own and the pair were greeted by a well-dressed servant who bowed courteously. "This way, honored knights," he said as he led them down the corridor. Ka and Kesarah followed the servant as he maneuvered down a series of richly decorated passageways before they came out to a set of decorative doors which again opened of their own accord. Passing through them, Ka and Kesarah found themselves assaulted by a barrage of light and sound as they were greeted by a sea of revelers in the midst of a vast ballroom. "It's gorgeous," Kesarah exclaimed beside Ka. "It is certainly impressive," Ka replied as he took in the sight before them. "I had no idea it would be this lively," Kesarah asked. Her earlier discomfort apparently vanished. Ka inclined his head slightly. "I suppose that is one way to describe it." "Introducing," the herald boomed, "Knights Kesarah Diligus and Kahan of the Jedi Order." The hall seemed to still for a moment as eyes turned to look at them. Ka shifted uncertainly, but Kesarah was all smiles as she dipped her head courteously. Ka followed her example and bowed as the party continued and the pair of them descended the stairs to join the rest of the partygoers. One could easily get lost in the throng of people, he realized, and he had to suppress his senses or risk being overwhelmed by the flood of thoughts and emotions he was picking up on. It was stifling in a way, but he steeled himself, understanding this was the task that had been given to him by the Order for this mission. "Hey," Kesarah called to him, smiling as she turned to look up at him coyly, "a promise is a promise." He blinked, not sure what she meant, which brought an impish gleam to her eyes as she held up a finger and wagged it playfully. "First dance, Ka," she took his hands in hers, guiding him towards the other dancers. "Make it memorable."